Fryette PLIR is a direct recording solution for the electric guitar, especially if you're addicted to using your beloved tube amplifiers but just don't have the type of recording environment that allows you to wind them up to the volume that they typically sound their best at. Well, historically, electric guitar was recorded in professional studios where generally volume wasn't an issue, right? Because the rooms that the amps were set up in, you know, were soundproofed, and the studios themselves were probably built in the industrial sections of the town. So, you know, engineers and guitarists could mic cabs and then crank stuff up to their heart's content, you know, with no complaining neighbors or landlords or significant others. So as the music industry shifted and recording budgets shrank, the boundaries between the professional and prosumer markets blurred. And we find ourselves in this era now where even guitar tracks for major artist releases are sometimes tracked in tiny home studios where miking cabinets and turning stuff up isn't an option. So some people have looked to modelers or software to replicate guitar sounds to varying degrees of success. But some other of us have never been able to quite let go of using our tube gear in these environments, so we forge ahead looking for other possible solutions to this dilemma. Okay, so how does one go about solving this problem? Well, in a very broad sense, you'd probably want a box that does a couple different things. And one of them would be, you know, being able to corral the volume of your amp down to a line level without compromising the sound or the dynamic response of your amplifier. Because after all, the main complaint about modelers isn't necessarily that they sound bad, but it's primarily that the tactile response that we're used to from our tube gear just doesn't really translate that well to that realm. So, you know, not everybody feels that way, but for those of us who do, it's a real issue, and real issues deserve real consideration and real solutions. So the second thing we need our box to do, once we've controlled the volume and preserved all the dynamic, juicy goodness of our amps, is to be able to duplicate the sound of our favorite speakers in our favorite cabs, right? Because we don't play our amplifiers without being plugged into a cabinet and through speakers, you know? Those three pieces are a part of a symbiotic whole. So if we had a box that did those two things, then we could just plug that directly into our recording interface and be up and recording and creating without compromise. So that's where the PLIR comes in to save the day, because it does those two things with aplomb and it adds some other little bells and whistles too. So let's give it a look. So if we look at the far left-hand side of the PLIR, we see a couple of switches that are almost hiding meekly, but these are actually the controls for the high and low frequency response of what we call the reactive load portion of the PLIR. This is the part of the box that is both mimicking the response of your amplifier being played into a speaker, while also allowing us to reduce the volume of the amplifier to a line level signal that we can send to a recording interface or a mixer for whatever line level lunacy you decide to get up to. So these switches allow us to fine-tune the frequency response of the reactive load depending on what your preferred playing volume might be. And for what it's worth, this is the same reactive load circuit that's in the award-winning Fryette Power Station. So the rest of the controls on the front panel are devoted to the second task that I outlined that we'd want our box to do, which is to replicate the tonal qualities of our favorite speakers and cabs. Within the PLIR, we have two different ways of achieving the same end. One with what is called the IR loader that we see on the top row of controls, which I'll explain more about in a minute, and also what's called the analog cabinet simulator that we see on the bottom row. And although these two different ways may not seem like much on the surface, the manner in which these can be implemented actually make for an unlimited amount of combination and variances for your productions that we'll definitely explore more in depth in a future video. Okay, so for those of you who are new to this world of cabinet simulation and emulation, I'll explain a couple of things in short. The current de rigueur for replicating the tonal characteristics of speaker cabinet combinations is through the usage of what we call IRs, which is short for impulse response. And impulse responses are typically stored in the form of wave files, and they are literally a recorded snapshot of a microphone, or like multiple microphones if you want, you can blend them, miking a speaker that's loaded into a cabinet. Okay, so, you know, if we think about it in terms of signal flow, in this model, we're gonna have our knocked down amplifier, line level sound, and we're gonna run that through the IR, which is processing the sound of our raw amplifier, right? Which is really no different than the traditional guitar amplification, where we run our amplifier into a cabinet and through a speaker. And that's processing the sound of our amplifier. It's just, in our traditional form, it's done in an analog domain, and now with IRs, it's done in the digital domain. So a lot of times people will load IRs up in their DAW or their recording software, but the PLIR has its own IR loader. So in that sense, it's like a one-stop shop for the job that I outlined earlier. The PLIR ships with 8 of its own IRs that were created specifically for this product, using speakers and cabinets that are decidedly Fryette in character and can't be found elsewhere at this time. Captured in the unit are IRs of Fryette's Deliverance and Fat Bottom cabs, as well as the newer Sound City and Ether models. We've got examples of the Fane F70G, Fane A60S, and Eminence P50, all captured with combinations of a Shure SM57 and a Royer R121. These take up banks 1 and 2, and with a grand total of 4 banks of storage available, there's more than enough room to load your favorite IRs into the PLIR as well. So if a total of 16 cab profiles wasn't enough, we also have this analog cab sim on board that's like a totally different animal altogether and can lead to some really rewarding places that are definitely off the well-trodden path of typical IR tones. Because of its more, it's like wider and more open nature, the analog cab sim immediately tends to shine in the clean and lower gain setting kind of territory. But for those of you who are into pushing the limits, there's undeniable potential for fresh tonal takes lurking in here. In terms of the playing experience overall, the analog cab sim has much more of an immediateness than playing through the IRs. IRs are like, you know, having the microphone and the mic pre and the monitors kind of translate stuff for you, where playing through the analog cab sim is more like, you know, sitting directly in front of your cabinet, without a bunch of stuff bouncing off the walls and everything. It's like you are right there, you know, with your amplifier and your speaker. So in the coming weeks, we're going to release some more videos detailing the potential of the PLIR as a tool for capturing and sculpting guitar sounds in a variety of genres and settings. Before we wrap this video up, I want to quickly talk about the back panel of the PLIR and quickly address its basic functionality so that you might get some ideas happening about how you might incorporate it into your own workflow. The first thing we want to look at is the amp in section and its attendant impedance switch. Here we can see that the PLIR can accommodate working with any amplifier and cabinet combo in your arsenal. The second area I want to draw your attention to would be the analog one out. This is a passive out that works even when your PLIR isn't plugged in. It's taking the amp signal post-reactive load and line level control so that you can send your line level amp sound out to your DAW to use with an IR that you load within your computer or just to be recorded raw and then reamped later on. The analog 2-out is interesting because we take the signal from the reactive load and pass it through the analog cab sim here. So if we run this out into one channel of our interface, we can also run the IR out into a second channel, and then we have the option of mixing both the IR affected signal and the analog cab sim. Super cool possibilities in play here. Of course, we also have a headphone amp with a dedicated effects loop that we can monkey around with until we pass out. The headphone amp is fed by the IR loader. More on this in future video stuffs. Finally, for now, we have the line input where we can run preamps or pedals or any other sound source you deem interesting through the IR loader, the analog cab sim, and also the full range analog out. Kind of like a full meal deal right here. So that's basically what's happening with the Fryette PLIR. Hopefully this video was illuminating and answered some of the basic questions you had about the unit. If you want to know more about its functionality, I highly suggest you download the instruction manual in the link below the video. And actually this time, I'm going to sit here until you do it. Ready, set, go. Come on, get the mouse going, click the link. Download the thing, it doesn't take that long. You do it? Come on, man, we don't have all day. All right, everyone, thanks for tuning in. Gonna play a little bit more music right now. Gonna be back soon with more PLIR content. Until then, stay safe, take it easy, like, subscribe, and do the bell icon thing, and we'll see you soon. Thanks, bye.